road that you travel on. There's one day here and the next day gone. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand, sometimes you turn your back to the wind. There's a world outside every darkened door where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
Abigail Adams was born in Weymouth, Massachusetts, in 1744 on the November 11th. She was born to William Smith, her father, and Elizabeth Quincy, her mother. She was the second of five children, with one brother and three sisters. After marriage with John Adams, Abigail went to live on John's farm in Braintree. After John became president, Abigail moved to the then unfinished White House, or President's House, as it was called then. In 1800, John and Abigail retired to Boston, Massachusetts, where Abigail lived out the rest of her days.
Abigail Adams had no formal education. She was taught to read and write at her home with only access to a large library of books.
Abigail's position in the White House was as First Lady or advisor to John Adams. In fact, she was so good at advising him and her opinions were so strongly backed, she was often called Mrs. President.
Abigail Adams is considered a founding father because John Adams considered Abigail his reporter, and they wrote about issues ranging from everyday life to the weighty work facing John Adams and the other founding fathers.
Fun facts are, in 1801, Abigail got a newfound puppy named Juno. Another fun fact is that Abigail was also a woman's right activist.